It's beer o'clock on Real Ale Craft Beer. Today we've got a beer from Brewery Bosteels and it's a bottle of the Powell Quack. Ale coming in at 8.4% ABV from Belgium. Here's the bottle cap. Let's get this beer out into a glass and see what we get. Always seen this about on the internet with the great big 750. Look at that. Didn't lose a drop. The big 750 with the cork. Cork top, and I fancied that, to be honest, I really did. But I was out in my local beer store in Cardiff a few months ago. And they had it here in a small bottle in a 330. I thought to myself, yes, I would like to review it in, you know, the lovely big cork bottle of 750. But I thought ordering it online, you got to pay a fee for the delivery. And I'm here anyway, I'm in the shop. I might as well pick it up, save myself a couple of quid and do it that way. And do it in the 330. Because you've still got a vast amount of beer at 8.5% ABV. Which is all very good, isn't it? Small one finger head. My Barry accent nearly came through then. I just stopped myself at the last minute. I just kind of paused it. Isn't it? I nearly said, in it. Such a Welsh thing, in it. Dreadful, dreadful pronunciations of words here in Barry, South Wales. But I stopped myself, we got the word out right. Anyway, beer in the glass. It's a lovely cherry red colour. Nice clarity on the beer. Carbonation kind of rising nicely up the middle. Yeah. Belgium double? Would I be right to call it a Belgium double? I think so. It's pushing towards triple territory at 8.5. I'd say a triple. Yeah, you could call this a triple if you really wanted to. I think a triple is probably 9% and over. This being 8.5, Belgium double. We'll call it a double. Let's get the aroma. Oh, blimey. Blimey, lovely. As I see cherry red and I get cherry, kind of red cherry aroma, but a little bit of black cherry as well. Loads of beautiful candied fruit. Spice. An element of dryness. Lemon. But most of all, candied fruit. This smells absolutely wonderful. Let's dive in. Cheers. And where do you start with this? What a powerful, powerful, powerful beer. In all the right senses. It's powerfully carbonated. It's powerfully sweet. It's powerfully candied fruit. It's hoppy. The yeast kicks in with all these slightly funky flavours. It's warming, it's rich, it's such a rich beer. But yes, as with the aroma, that candied fruit, but mixed with that kind of white pepper spice, middle, back end taste, it's mesmerising. And now I'm picking up a little bit of bitterness on the back end from the hops used in the beer. It's a real sipper, this one. It's a beer which I'm standing here reviewing it now, taking mouthful after mouthful. Mm. But if I had a second bottle, if I went back to Cardiff and bought a second bottle, brought it back here, I would sit in my living room, pour it, maybe turn the Xbox on, do a little bit of gaming, but this would last me about an hour, well over an hour. I would sit and relax with it and sip it gently and kind of connoisseur it, get the aroma every now and again, feel that spice, feel that warming body, feel that warming taste as it goes down the inside of the channel there of your stomach. It's a warming sensation. It's a classic beer. And who'd have thought I would ever get to the stage where I'd actually like these beers. When these beers were first presented to me, even a few years ago, I didn't like them. I didn't understand them. They were too strong. All I would pick up was like this weird kind of... I couldn't even put my finger on what I was tasting. And the alcohol, I would pick up the alcohol. And that was a young palate. That was a palate that was untrained. And all of a sudden I carried on drinking these beers. And somewhere along the line it clicked. Something just went pow, bang, in my brain. And I thought, right, okay, I'm tasting this candied fruit. And then I'm picking up white pepper and spice and the yeast and the carbonation, and it all mixes together and it all comes together in your mind and you start to enjoy the beer. So if you're new to craft beer, if you're new to these Belgian beers, don't give up. Don't give up. I'm not saying to drink them every single week. Buy one, drink it. If you don't like it, fine. Try and struggle on with it. Try and drink it. Give it a month. Give it 2 months. Buy another. Buy something different. Buy another one. Give it another week, 2 weeks, a month, 2 months. Buy another one. And I'm pretty sure over the amount of time, it might take you 6 months. You'll enjoy the beer, I promise you. If you like your American hoppy IPAs, if you like any of these big, pardon me, Imperial Stouts, Stouts, Porters, but like me, you struggle to begin with, keep on going. You'll get to like it, I'm pretty sure. Rating then for Quack, Brewery Bostiles, 1791. Wow. Bought a little bottle, tried it, liked it, loved it. Would I buy the big 750 cork bottle and maybe crack it open New Year's Eve or Christmas Day or Boxing Day? Yeah. Of course I would. Brilliant. This beer's a 9 out of 10. It's a 9 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Put your comments in the comments box. Please subscribe to our daily beer reviews and cheers.